What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the second part of Android Studio tutorials. So in the last lesson, we have learned about the text view and adding some of the codes into the text view to make it look better. So today we are going to learn about button and some of other techniques that we can use in the widgets in case of XML. So let's get started. I'm going to the Android Studio. So we have the last project, first app. I'm gonna open that. Okay, so we have the app. Now in the last lesson, we have discussed about adjusting the text view. So I'm gonna go to the text and I want to change the match parent into wrap content now. So I'm changing it into wrap content. Okay, wrap content. Now you can see the text again came to the starting point. So okay, now all we have to do is just go to the design again. Now we can see here is the palette as I have discussed. In the palette, we can choose many widgets and many other views and different kind of things. So today I'm going to show you how to use the button. So button is nothing but click it. When you click it, as you have seen in many other applications, we have a login screen, and when the user type the login username and ID and all the things, then you can finally press the button called login in order to get logged into the application. So now we are going to drag the button into this activity. So I'm gonna left clicking on the button, and by keep pressing the mouse click, I'm dragging it into this activity, and I'm keeping into the center, and you can see XY directions can be seen over here. Anyway, I'm just keeping it. Now you can see that the button is over in the activity. Now we are going to the text again, and you can see in case of the button, we have a ID specified as button and the layout width height as we have seen in the text view. Then we have the central horizontal, which move the button from the top right corner or top left corner into the center, and here is vertical and horizontal. So anyway, we have the text for the button, and you can see we have used the same method, that's the Android colon text equal to my first app, and this is that was the text view, and we have used the same method in the button. So some of the features or some of the lines that we have written in the XML file are similar to all other widgets and other views, so we can repeatedly use the same thing. But in case of the ID are unique for each contents that we have added into this XML file. So if you have added the button as an ID for this button, let me show you. What if I copy the same ID into the text view, you can see now it shows an error that the ID is a unique that you can copy and paste it again, but you have to make a simple change in that ID so that you can again use the same. So let me show you. If I'm using the button one, now the problem is solved that you can use a different or unique ID for each the widgets. So now you have a clear idea about using the ID and some of the same codes that we use in the activity main.xml or the XML layout. So now you can see we have a button over here, and here is a text view. Now let me show you some of the codes that you can use in the button. So let me type Android background equal to, so we have seen when I type Android colon background equal to, you can see some of the options also pop up. We have seen some of the pop up here which shows that at Android then colon and at color slash color accent, and likewise we have a color primary dark, then mid map, icy launcher, and many other things. So in the first case, we can see that at Android colon we can use the pre-built colors into the background of this button. So let me show you the first one. So I'm gonna right double clicking on that. So now what I have to do is simply type for color. So when I type color, you can see a lot bunch of different colors have been appeared. So when I go with the black, you can see button is changing the background color into black. So when I go with the white, you can see we got a white background. Now let's go with something unique. I'm gonna go with the hollow blue bright, and now you can see you got a blue background. So likewise, we can use the pre-built colors from this through this at android:color/, then your specified color, you can choose the pre-built colors. Now you can also choose something different. So let me go with again. Okay, now you can see the second one, we have the @color/color_accent, which is a color that we define in this Android program or Android this app program. So let's press the second one, that's the color accent. Now you can see the color accent shows something a pink color. So that means we are using a color in from this project itself. Now let's move the color accent into color primary and see what are the changes we can get. Now you can see we got a blue, and again I'm adding a dark again into this. Now you can see the blue with something more dark color. So that means these things are defined as the user made this application, and at Android is something that is predefined. So what you can change this, so this is a variable, just like a variable, you can always change it with your own preferences. You can always change this text into something color, my app, or something, anything you can do with that. So all you have to do is, in order to get this area, you have to go to the app, then go to resources, and from that you have to move to the values where you can find colors.xml, and blam, you can see here is the color primary dog, and color accent. Let's move and change the color primary into something this one or something like this. Okay, now we have changed the color primary dark into something different color. Now let's go to the activity_main.xml, and you can see we can reflect the changes that we have made on the background of this button. And the same as that, we have got the notification area as same as that color, because the notification area uses same color variable. So likewise, now we have to adjust the text color so that we can easily find the button name. So now the button color, text color is black. Now we have to add one more line, same as we have written, Android text color equal to, again I'm using the pre-built Android color white. Now you can see we can able to easily identify the button name now. So that is how to use a Android XML lines of code. So now you can see the text, we can see the Android text equal to my first app. So show something a yellow background, that is, there is something that you can clear the issue. So there is some error. So now you can see hard coded string should be used at string resource. So that means for the better performance of your Android app in all kind of devices, you have to convert this native lines of text into a string variable. So all you have to do is press the left alt and enter, and you can see now you get a window which says that extract string resource. Just double click on that. Now you can see here is the string name, which goes to be the string name, and this is the value of that string that is same as what we have written at here. So when I press OK, now you can see @string/my_first_app is written as something that we can identify what it is actually is. But in this case, we can't edit directly from here. Let's suppose I'm gonna add one more line, my first app into my first application. So my first application, and now you can see that is an error that the string is not found. The Android Studio can't find the string. So we have to declare, or we have to change the value of the string from the string.xml files. What I'm going to do is going back and setting it as first_app. So this is the name of the string. Now we have to move to the strings.xml from the values folder inside the resource. So we have the string.xml open. Now you can see this is string name is my first app, and here is the string value. Likewise, you can see the string name of the Android app, that is app_name equal to first app. So we can always change the app Android app name directly from here itself. So let's say I want to change the first app into my first app into application. Okay, now we have changed And also I want to change this app into again application. Now we have made changes inside the string, which doesn't show any kind of errors. So we have done successfully. I'm closing the string.xml file. Now you can see my first application, we have changed the app name and the text string value. Now likewise, we have to change the button into something like press me or click me. I want to say it as click me. Now you can see I have changed it, but even though we have to extract the text as a string resource, so press left alt and enter. Now click enter again and you can change that into a string resource called click underscore me. Now press the OK. And now we can see there is no any kind of errors inside this. So at the top you can see here in the scroll bar, you can see if there is an error, you can see a horizontal line like this. This line is never used, so we have to remove that. And now you can see there is no any other kind of errors. So finally we have done. So what we have to do next is that go to the design, and now we have almost everything about XML coding. So the next part is going through the programming, that is Java programming language. So that will be covered in the part 3. So in the part 2, we have already discussed about using a proper usage of the XML codes. So likewise, you can always experiment many other codes, like let me show you. So Android text style, you can use the bold, italic or normal. Let's go with the italic. Now you can see the text changed into italic style. Likewise, you can always copy the same thing, paste it over here. No matter, in case of a button, I will always suggest going with a bold, that make it a little more beautiful. You can always change these values into something as you have defined. So let's change the width, or width into 200. Then now you can see the 200 is an incorrect value, so that we have to also add extension for this 200. So in case of buttons, we have to add the width as DP, but in case of a text view, we have to add the text size as ESP. So there are two differences between this. So you have to follow DP in all other cases, but instead of DP, you have to use ESP in case of the text sizes. So if you're interested in Android Studio, you may be using a lot of time around this and you may be spending more time. So using a white background literally causes eye pain. So likewise, I always suggest going with a black or dark background. So in my case, when I create a large project, I used to go with the black. In order to change the Android Studio background, you can always go to the file, then you can go to the settings, and from the settings you can move to the appearance, where you can choose, and the appearance will be like this. Just double click and go to the appearance, and you can change the theme from IntelliJ to Dracula. I always suggest using Dracula when you are doing by yourself, but in my case, I'm showing you this tutorial, so the Dracula theme may not be look really perfect. So anyway, let me show you the Dracula. Just hit the apply button, and now you can see all you have to do is simply press the OK. Okay, so I always suggest going with the Dracula theme. That make little more sense than Android Studio for a longer time without any kind of issues. So I will be continuing with the white screen so that you can understand what I'm doing actually in the Android Studio. If you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. And if you have any kind of questions, as I said, you can always ask in the comment section below of each videos. And stay tuned, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done before. So thanks for watching. Peace out.